An Academy. Let's crack it.
Hey guys, this is Adya. This video is going to be about CLAT 2022 prep guide sort of thing, which is equally beneficial for the retakers as well as the people who are in standard 12th. However, there's a caveat here that I was not a dropper, so I don't have much specific advice for the droppers, but I'll try to help you guys out with to the best of my abilities. I have some advices that I've noted down in this Word doc. Also, this doc will be shared with you in the description, so you can check it out there for later references. So we shall start now. So obviously some basic things about CLAT is it's going to be a paper of 150 marks, 1 marks for positive, minus 0.25 for negatives. For every question that you get wrong, there's this slot of 2 hours. You have 150 questions. You have 5 sections, English, legal, logical, current affairs, and quants. I have listed down the section-wise topics that you must cover. And I feel this is very important that you just list down all the topics that you need to cover in a particular section. That helps you to keep a track of your preparation and check your progress throughout the year. So for English, you have reading comprehension. For grammar, you have parts of speech, figure of speech, vocabulary-based questions, which can be synonyms, antonyms. Then we have tenses, active and passive voice, prepositions, spotting errors, models, articles, and subject-verb agreement. I'll tell you the sources to prepare for all these sections later on, but now it's for now. We'll just see what are the broader topics that you need to cover in all these 5 sections. Then we have current affairs. So current affairs, it's basically all the kind of relevant news that you can see happening in the span of 1 year, that is from July 2020 to the month of your exam, preferably 2 weeks before your exam. So for current affairs, although these are very broad topics, politics, history, geography, strategy, international events, science and technology, but it broadly covers all sorts of genre of current affairs that is asked. So there's no such broader classification of topics. You need to specially cover like everything and anything, but there's a smart way to go about it, which I'll be talking about later in this video. You also need to focus on static GK. Now static GK is not going to be like any GK. Static GK means the GK for CLAT, which is related to the topics which have been in news. Like the current affair topics, ka static GK ka portion is the only relevant portion for CLAT. You don't really need to mug up everything. So don't like just buy the static GK books and start mugging it up. No use. Then you have legal aptitude. Even though in the new pattern, you don't really need to know the laws or like everything about, you know, the legal field, which you'll be eventually studying in the law school. However, they expect you to know the basics of law. Now, what I mean by basics of law is you need to know about torts, contracts, not in detail, but like the very, you know, the level one sort of knowledge. Then you need to know about your Constitution of India. You need to know all the landmark judgments that have been passed in the span of 1 year from now. Then you need to know about the legal maxims, the legal terms, any new development in the field of law, be it a new appointment made, be it a new legislation passed, any new amendment that has been made, or you know, any kind of treaty that has been signed, any, such kind of stuff broadly. Then for logical reasoning, you have 2 things. One is logical reasoning, other one is critical reasoning. So critical reasoning covers majority of the portion of your logical reasoning questions in the new pattern. So your major focus should be on covering critical reasoning portion, that is assumption, conclusion, arguments, inference, cause and effect, premise, and then you should focus on logical reasoning, which is number and alphabetic series, puzzles, direction sense, blood relations, syllogisms. I think these are almost all the topics that you need to know to just like score a decent marks in this section. Also, one thing which you all need to keep in mind is you can never have a very you know, like specified syllabus for CLAT, because CLAT has a tendency to give a surprise element in the paper. So you can never really be sure that only these are the points which is going to be asked, which is going to be in your question paper. So don't just think like, okay, I covered only these particular topics, so anything apart from this will have utterly no chance to come in your paper. It might have a chance, but these are the topics on the basis of all the past year papers that CLAT has frequently and like almost always asked. So I think it's just enough for you guys. Then we have quants. So quants is like almost all the topics that you have covered from class 8 to standard 10th, which is like number system, HCF, LCM, ratio, proportions, simplification, percentage, average, age, calculation, time and work, distance, speed, algebra. Algebra also like basic algebra, simplification sort of thing. Then you have quadratic equations, permutations and combinations. You can leave that because you just need to know the basics. Again, all the basics of all these topics you need to know. You don't really need to know the advanced mathematics here, because again, it's like a small 15 marks section, but it contains equal weightage. A lot of people, I'll be talking about this later in the video, that a lot of people, they start with the mindset to just like let go quants and not even prepare for it, because it's either difficult or you don't have interest in maths. But whatever, you need to understand that this section has relevance, has importance in your CLAT paper, and you need to cover it equally well. Now, before you start your preparation, you have some preliminary steps that you need to make sure of. Figure out your do's and your don'ts. Let's just talk about your don'ts first, because a lot of people commit this mistake. The biggest don't is not starting at the right time. So even if you have made up your mind that you're gonna give CLAT or you're gonna retake CLAT again this year, this is the time to start. You cannot be like, abhi to ek saal bacha hai, so I'll just like start 2-3 mahine baad or like whatever. No. Similarly, standard 12 students cannot be like, I have 1 year left plus I have boards to give, so I'll just focus on boards and like leave CLAT for later. That's not gonna happen. Study just for either 2-3 hours or even 1 hour a day, but just study regularly, stay consistent. That is the key to crack CLAT and get into some top NLU. Next is not picking up the right source. So there's this myth that if you just cover like 5-6 sources for every particular topic, then you are well off, otherwise not. I believe that is a very, you know, huge misconception among all the students. It's important to cover one or two sources in depth rather than covering, like skimming through a lot of sources, because eventually that won't fetch you a lot of knowledge depth, which is what CLAT has been testing in its new pattern. You need to know the issues in depth and not like know about everything without going in detail, because you have passage based questions. So from like particular one topic, you are asked 5-6 questions. So it's important that you know about that topic much, much more in depth when compared to the previous type of question papers. Then not giving marks and analyzing them thoroughly. So this is again the biggest mistake. So a lot of people ask, like their accuracy is not increasing, their number of attempts is not increasing. It's just because you're not analyzing your mock thoroughly. We'll discuss about how to analyze mock later in the video. Then leaving QT, as I talked about, a lot of people tend to give up on this section without even trying to attempt it, without even trying to learn it or practice it. You have one whole year. I think that's like more than enough to gain a good command on this section. So it's really not ideal to just leave this section and like just go ahead with it, because 15 marks is huge and you never know how the paper is going to turn. What if your strongest section on the exam day gets you the most difficult questions, and then eventually you are short in marks. So it's important to treat all the sections important and equally well. Then not understanding the difference between the old and new CLAT pattern. So there's been significant change in the new and the old pattern. It's important to strategize your preparation according to the demands of the new pattern, which is basically you need to know in depth about the topics that you are covering, which is to have a very stringent reading habit, which is to develop a comprehending ability, which is to focus on the key words, focus on the key transitions in the passages, to read between the lines. And all these habits will eventually get better when you are consistently reading and practicing on all of these skills. Then what are the some essential things that you need to cover is to stay consistent. I cannot emphasize on this enough. A lot of people tend to prioritize their boards over CLAT, which is an obviously normal thing. But then if you really want to track CLAT along with your boards, you need to manage your time between the two. I think both are equally important. And after a particular point of time, CLAT becomes more important than your boards. So you need to divide your time as to during what span of time you're going to focus more on boards and during what span of time you're going to focus more on CLAT. That needs to be a smart decision on your side and depending upon your circumstances. Then keeping a list of topics to cover handy. I think that is the reason I listed on all the topics that you need to cover in all the five sections, because it's important that you keep all the topics in front of you, and it helps you to check that you have covered enough and whatever is left for you to cover. Then there has to be daily rituals. So like a lot of people have these morning rituals, they get up early, then they just like arrange their bed, then they make a morning drink or something, they work out or they meditate. Accordingly, you need to have some CLAT rituals, which has to be done every single day. They are reading. Now, what you have to read will again cover later on. Skimming through news. So do not like just collate your current affairs for a month or a week, because eventually it will just get pile up. And that backlog will be a big demotivating factor for you. And so you won't be able to eventually cover them all, and you will like have a bundle of, you know, backlogs. And that will not be a good thing for you guys. Plus, if you are going to enroll in some coaching, do not rely on attending the classes from recordings. Attend the live class so that you're not again left with a lot of backlogs and you're not behind what's going on in your coachings. It's important to stay with the pace of your coaching, with the pace of the fellow students at your coaching, so that you feel confident and you can actually analyze your performance and your preparation level. Then you have, don't let setbacks convert to quitting. Now what happens is your mock scores, your preparation level will never stay consistent. There will be times that your mock score will drop off drastically. There will be times when you will not be able to focus on your CLAT preparation well because of whatsoever reason, maybe boards pressure, maybe you fall sick, maybe you have some other thing going on, a family function or whatever. So there will be time that you won't be able to give adequate time to your preparation, and you will feel disheartened, you'll feel demotivated, you will feel pressurized, but that doesn't mean that you're going to give up. That only means is you're going to sit, strategize and start again. And now the last tip is practice scientific methods to stay motivated and make the process enjoyable. So in the end of this document, I have linked some videos for you guys, the motivational videos, which also consists of some scientific tips that helps you to study more effectively. So do try them. We will now start. Okay, I have something more for the preliminary steps, that is decide whether you need a coaching to guide you. So it's important to decide on the right time that are you going to enroll yourselves in a coaching or you're going to do self-study. I think self-study is also like equally beneficial and in fact more beneficial than coachings, provided you have enough motivation that comes from within you and you have that caliber to stay consistent, to stay committed to your goals. Plus, without coaching, you still would be in need of some materials, because honestly, guys, we have very less material in the market for CLAT preparation. So you would need some study materials and mocks for which you need to buy the study materials from any coaching. So when I say that you don't need a coaching, I don't mean to say that you don't need the study materials as well. You do need the study material, and there are a lot of coachings that provide the study packages. So you can just like buy the study packages and like go ahead with your self-study preparation. That's it. That's like a nice way. Keep an eye on the consortium. The consortium has a tendency to make a lot of changes, maybe change the pattern, maybe change the mode of examination or whatever. So just keep an eye on the developments done from the consortium's point of view and have a routine. Now from routine, I don't mean timetable, because timetable has honestly never worked for me. But if it works for you, well and good. If it doesn't, have a task table. So before you go to your bed, you need to make a list of the things that you need to cover tomorrow and have to cover tomorrow before you go to your bed the next night. So make a to-do list, or make a weekly target list, or make an hourly list if you think that you cannot stay consistent with your goals or targets. So make an hourly list that in the next 1 hour, I'm going to cover, say, a sectional test, or I'm going to learn about assumptions. On the next 2 hours, I'm going to give a mock. So whatever works for you accordingly, but have a routine. A routine helps you to cover your topics, cover your portions more efficiently, and you don't actually feel demotivated. Plus, you don't have a lot of backlogs because you see that you're improving. You are covering a lot of things. You're tick marking your checklist, and that helps you subconsciously to gain confidence in your process. Then I have something for droppers. See, you guys have already invested a year, or say 6 months, or like 3 months, whatever, for the CLAT preparation. So you guys fairly have an edge on the people who are just starting, right? Plus, you have the idea of the basic requirements of CLAT. You've already figured out your strengths and weaknesses, which I hope you have done. And you have practiced enough. So you might be left with some additional time, which is not meant to waste, which is not meant to just sleep and like stroll around, which is not meant to just like do type pass or to just watch web series. I mean, you can have your entertainment part for sure, but these extra time, this extra 1 year which you have got, I think it's important to utilize it in a way to prepare yourself for the eventual purpose that you are taking a drop for, that is law school, right? So use this whole 1 year to not only prepare for CLAT and ensure a very good rank, but also to prepare for your law school. Because honestly, law school doesn't give you time to prepare, to accommodate to its needs, to adjust in the law school. You will enter and boom, you'll have competitions, you'll have syllabus, you'll have everything to do by your own without any, you know, like time to chill out or settle down. So in this 1 year, it's important to work on your areas, on the weaker areas, which you think are essential in law school, be it your communication skills, be it your public speaking skills, be it your researching skills, be it your writing skills, whatever you think that you lack in, and whatever is important for a student to, you know, like stay ahead of fellow people in law school. So you can work on those areas. You can start reading some really nice journals, or law journals, of course. So you can read some nice blogs that deals with legal developments. You can read some nice novels. You can finish the Thinking Like a Lawyer book like in 1 month or so. So you can cover up some standard journals. You can improve the standard of the reading that you're supposed to do. Not only will it help you to have a more stronger command on your English, critical, and legal section, it will also prepare you well for your law school life. And you will obviously have an edge when you enter the law school with all other people. So do that. Also, for the droppers, forget what happened in 2021. What I mean here is to not forget the mistakes you did, or not forget the things that you've learned. I mean to forget that you couldn't crack CLAT. It's just a fresh beginning. It's all done and dusted now. This whole year, 2021 and 2022, will be a completely new beginning for you. You guys have got another chance. So just make the best out of it. Don't let any regret, any kind of guilt to be there in your mind while you're preparing for CLAT 2022. And yeah, I think that's it. Now we'll go to subject-wise strategy. So let's start with English. I think it's very simple to understand what you need to cover in a subject like English. So you will have three types of questions. One is passage-based comprehension questions. Other is grammar. Third is, which you can say, the literary device, the tone of the author, so on and so forth. So these three types of questions can be prepared with some very less sources. For editorials, so for passage for comprehension based questions, you can read editorials, especially from the Hindu. I highly recommend it, that because not only the standard, but the length of the passages in the Hindu, the editorials in Hindu, are at par with what is expected in CLAT paper. So it will be a great practice. You can also read this book, Thinking Like a Lawyer. It also helps you in a lot of ways with your vocabulary, with understanding the tone of passage, with understanding a lot of legal terms, legal philosophy, so which will help you in the legal section as well, plus in your law schools as well. because we had to like read again Thinking Like a Lawyer in the first year of law school. So that's like a good practice. Or because you have a lot of time, you can also choose to read any standard novel. I used to read John Grisham. So if you like that, you can do that. I used to also read Sidney Sheldon. So if you like that, you can use that as well. Any standard novel, don't read Chetan Bhagat. Not because it's not a nice novel or something, just because you need to read the novels that is hard to interpret, that has a lot of difficult vocabulary terms that helps you to eventually strengthen your grasp on English. So apologies to everyone who's a Chetan Bhagat fan. I used to be one, but yeah. So next thing is about grammar. For grammar, you have Brennan Martin. Brennan Martin is like the standard grammar book. If you are weak at grammar, you need to, you know, like understand everything from the basics, go for Brennan Martin. Otherwise, English is Easy is also a really, really nice book, which deals with grammar from your basics to the standards in a very concise and short manner. So if you just need to revise the grammar rules and just know about it, you can just like refer to English is Easy. For vocabulary, obviously, when you'll be reading some standard novel or the editorials, you'll eventually come across a lot of words that you don't know the meaning of. So while you read the tutorials, have a habit to look up the word then and there whenever this comes off in your sentences. Know the meaning and try to practice those words in your like speaking habit. So whenever you communicate in English, try to use those words in your speech. It will help you to remember the words. Otherwise, you have WordPad made easy. High frequency word list. So when you Google high frequency word list for GRE or IELTS on Google, so there's a list of say 300 words, and those 300 words are some words that you'll eventually find in a lot of editorial passages or in a lot of books or novels that you're referring to. So these high frequency words, if you just learn the list, if you're able to learn the list and remember, it will be good for you. Synonyms, antonyms is obviously when you read the vocabulary, when you just like learn the words, have a habit to also look up of, let's look on the synonyms of the like the word that you're searching for, and also look for the antonym of that particular word. So a lot of time you know the meaning, but then you don't know the antonym, the opposite of that particular word. So when you're searching for a word, just have a habit to look for the antonyms as well. Literally, devices and tone. I think there are a lot of great YouTube videos on literary devices and tone of the authors. So you can just refer to YouTube and like make notes, have conceptual clarity and make notes so that you can revise at the end moment whatever you have learned. It's all very theoretical based questions, and it will only be, you know, you'll only be able to mark them right if you remember the rules, the terms exactly. Also for practicing reading comprehension, I think the previous year papers from IELTS or CLAT are great way to practice. So you can just like, if you have past year papers, or you can just download it from, you know, online sources and just get it printed, because you will probably be having an offline paper. So just like practice your reading comprehension from in like from the past year papers of IELTS or CLAT. You don't really need to buy a reading comprehension book to just practice these, because you already have a lot of passages to practice with. Then for current affairs, so current affairs can be done in two ways. One is to read like daily, which is slightly difficult for a lot of us because we might have or might not have the time to read a lot of articles on a daily basis. What I used to do was to just like watch 3-4 study IQ videos before I go to sleep. And obviously the study IQ videos, I think, are a great source to stay updated with whatever is happening around you. Other than that, you can also read, you should read the news articles from Scrawl, The Wire and Life Mint, because I've seen passages directly taken from these three sources in your CLAT papers. So just install a habit of reading the news articles from Scrawl, Wire and Life Mint. The benefit here is they are short, they're easy to understand, and plus they cover all the, you know, the major, the relevant news that's been happening inside in and outside your country. Then you can also like, you should pick up 8 topics per month starting from July 2021. You need to pick up 8 topics that have been in news consistently, or that have some national or international or some very cultural, religious significance pick up those topics, and you'll obviously be able to find out, you know, that these topics are in news, they are being talked about, they are being covered by a lot of sources. So these are important. Thus, you need to just pick up those 8 topics per month, Google search them, search why did this topic come in news, how did it originate, if it is a legal topic, understand what are the legal terms associated with it, what are the articles that has been in news, what are the laws that has been in use just because of this whole particular incident. So if you're preparing for current affairs, you might as well prepare for legal aptitude side by side for those questions which are based on current legal happenings. So whenever you just pick up 8 particular topics, 1, Google it. 2, have a process of making notes. So when you're making notes, you need to cover 3 things. The historical background, why, how did this whole incident originate, how and why. 2, what is the issue that has made this news come into relevance? And 3, what is the latest development? Now, 4th thing which a lot of people forget to do is to search about all the organizations, all the laws, all the people that have been in news. So if you have a news that also involves some particular organization or some particular famous personality, search about them too. Search about the articles that have been in news. That is the static portion that you need to cover for current affairs. So you not only need to know what has happened, you also need to know about the things that are included in that particular news. And you need to know about them in depth. So if there's an organization involved, you need to know when did that organization get established, who is the president of that organization, who is the secretary of the organization, where is that organization situated, and all that stuff, right? So I hope I'm making myself clear here. I've already written them down here. So for your later reference, you'll always have this. How to check your preparation level, especially in current affairs. So there are a lot of sources that take up monthly quizzes. So you can just like take one of those quizzes and know your preparation level. Other than that, there are a lot of Telegram channels, coaching channels on Telegram, which releases these weekly GK tests or weekly, you know, like free compendium for GK. So I subscribed, I joined 2 Telegram channels, which was from Law Prep Tutorial and Legal Edge. So they used to give these free GK quizzes, free GK compendium, and free important topics to be covered every month. So just subscribe to any 2 channels of your choice. And that will be also a good way to practice for your GK and like know what's happening. If you, in case you missed out something, they will be more often than not covering it. Then you have legal aptitude. So legal aptitude is all about reading. There's no shortcut in legal aptitude. In fact, while attempting your paper, you can leave reading your current affairs passage, but you cannot leave a single line in your legal aptitude passage. So it's important to read. Now, what you need to read is not only the legal news, you also need to know the legal theory. Now, the legal theory can be very basic theory. So there's this book called A.P. Bhardwaj, which deals with the basis of law, which deals with the very basic things that you need to know for CLAT examination. So you have 1 year from now, you should cover A.P. Bhardwaj for all the legal theory. Apart from that, have a habit of reading legal news. So there are particular legal websites where you get the news, which is relevant for legal aptitude, that is Live Law and Bar and Bench. So when you read these 2 websites, you'll be aware of the legal developments that's been taking place. Also, when you read these types of articles, you'll come across a lot of Latin maxims and legal maxims. A lot of time CLAT asks the meaning of these basic legal and Latin maxims. Now, again, you don't need to take out a list of thousands of or hundreds of Latin maxims and legal maxims, like start cramming it up. The practice is to just know the basic legal and Latin maxims, and that you will obviously come across through the span of 1 year while you are staying consistent with your reading of legal news, while you are reading AP Bhardwaj. So you will come across some basic Latin and legal maxims, and that's it. You need to know and remember the meaning of all those terms. I have listed down some examples of the basic legal and Latin maxims. You can see here status quo, force majeure, mens rea, ex post, ex ante, etc. For logical reasoning, so again, it's divided into 2 sections, right? We have logical reasoning and we have critical reasoning. We'll start with critical reasoning. So how I prepared for critical reasoning was I listed down the topics that critical reasoning portion covers. And then one by one, I used to watch all those videos related to that particular topic on YouTube just to understand the concept, understand what that term means, how to figure out that sentence in that passage, how to attempt the questions that deals with those particular topics. So if you have you have assumptions, so just like search statement assumption on YouTube, go through the nice videos. Now nice videos are of course the ones which have got like which have really got a nice likes. So just like check those videos out, understand the basis, understand the concept behind that particular topic, and then start practicing sectional tests. For sectional tests, you have this book called Verbal and Nonverbal Reasoning by Alsa Agarwal or M.K. Pandey. So first you complete Alsa Agarwal completely, only then switch to M.K. Pandey, otherwise it's like enough. Plus, IELTS past year questions are also a very good source to prepare for critical reasoning, because CLAT has like recently evolved their logical reasoning section to put more emphasis on critical reasoning, but IELTS has always been so. IELTS has really standard critical reasoning questions. So even if you're not planning to attempt IELTS, it's important, it's a good practice to just go through the critical reasoning questions from IELTS past year question paper. If you have done till here, only then try to switch to GMAT critical reasoning questions. What people do is basics pata nahi hai, but GMAT ke questions bana rahe hai because a lot of seniors, a lot of YouTube channels says so. Do not fall for this trap. You will not be able to solve these questions unless you are very, very clear about the concepts. So just start with basics, YouTube, then Alsa Agarwal, then IELTS, and then GMAT. For logical, there's no trick. I hope if you're enrolled in some coaching or if you're watching some nice videos, they will give you some basic tricks to solve such kind of questions. But practice is the only way through which you can like get a command on logical reasoning. Again, Alsa Agarwal book is a nice way to practice logical reasoning. Quants. I'm again and again requesting you guys to not skip through this section. It's just the start of your preparation. You have one whole year. Even if you know nothing in maths, even if you hate maths like I did, you need to read, you need to study, you need to prepare for quants as well and equally well. So how to go about for quants? We have the list of topics. All of these topics we have covered in class 8th, 9th, and 10th. So there's nothing very new and very alien to you. You need to revise it. For revising, read the concepts or like study the concepts on YouTube. I think YouTube is such a great platform to have all sorts of knowledge that you're looking for in like lesser time, free of cost. So just like search particular topics on YouTube, search like profit and loss on YouTube. Now they'll explain you in detail what profit and loss is, what is the formula, how to go about it. Once you have the conceptual clarity, start by practicing examples from Alsa Agarwal book or NCERT book if you have any, borrowed from cousins or anywhere. Plus if you have like online sources available, perfect. Just start with practicing examples. When you practice examples, you see the process that they have adopted, and they might have adopted some, you know, like shortcut processes or some easy process than what you thought it to be. So start with examples first and then try to practice sectional tests. For sectional test, you can either practice the questions from your books or from if you have some coaching compendium, or just like go for the past year question papers. Then to just, if you are weak at remembering the formula, the cubes, the squares, the tables, just make a chart of everything, paste it in your room or wherever you just frequently visit, and like go through it once a day, you'll be good to go. Next we have is how to analyze mocks. So what people do is, in fact, what I used to do was in my initial days was to just give the mocks, check my total marks and just like leave it. But that is the thing which you do wrong. The practice, especially in this time when you're just starting your preparation, should be to start with 3 mocks. Give a sample paper mock. Sample paper can be from past year. Sample paper can be from any coaching's free sample paper available. And then solve CLAT 2020 and CLAT 2021 question paper, because they both are on your new pattern only. So give these three marks in, say, a week, and then sit with all these three marks and then analyze. So what do I mean by analyze is to check time allotment. So were you able to finish your paper within time? Yes or no? No, then how many questions did you attempt? Now, not only check the attempt, like the total attempt of the whole paper, but also check the attempts of particular sections. So you need to know that how many questions in particular section did you attempt? Were you able to attempt and attempt it correctly, right? That will help you to understand your sections that are strong for you and the section that you are not so good at. And that will eventually help you to pinpoint your weaknesses and your strengths. So just make a list of total attempts from these sample papers, from these three marks, total attempts, section-wise attempts, and then how much time did each section take for you? Now this, if it is something in the range of, say, you take 15 minutes for GK, 15 minutes for Quants, 35 minutes for legal, 30 minutes for logical, and 30 minutes for English, or say like 25 minutes for English, it's perfect. If it's somewhere like fluctuating between 35 to 37, like 2-3 minutes aage peeche, it's also perfect. 5 minutes max, okay. But like if you're exceeding this time, that means you are lagging somewhere in that particular section. That section ideally should not take more than what I just said right now. So if it's taking you more, figure out which is the place that you are getting wrong. If you don't just understand your mistake, how will you ever improve it? So that is the reason why a lot of people don't see increase in their accuracy or increase in the number of attempts, because they don't understand, they don't figure out the place that they are lagging in. So it's very important to thoroughly analyze the first three marks that you will be giving in. You need to know the questions that you have left and the questions that you got wrong. The ones that you got wrong, you need to understand, why did you get it wrong? What was the problem with that section, with that particular question that you didn't understand about? And the questions that you left, now, if you leave some question, that means you don't know about it, right? And it's completely fine to not know about something, but it's not fine to just leave it there. You need to go read up on that particular topic and then come again and solve that question and see that if you were able to solve it properly or not, right? Then you can practice sectional tests to get a hold of topics. So now once you have a clarity in your mind that these are the topics that I am good at and these are the topics that I'm not so good at, so now you need to start working on your weaker areas. So you can practice sectional tests on those particular topics that you're not good at. So when you do that, you will be able to improve eventually, and that is what you need. Plus, mocks in the initial days get too hectic and people often tend to give up. Like what I used to do was, when I used to give a paper of say 2 hours, I used to get tired and I used to just zone out and I used to leave the paper in mid, or like attempt 3 sections out of 5 and just leave the paper. But then that was of no use. That's just you wasting 2 hours and plus a mock. You're not here to just like give up, right? If you have this habit of giving up right from day one, you will be giving up all through the year, and eventually this whole year or that hard work you're putting will get into like complete waste. So it's important that you understand that all this process is what that you have signed up for. If you have prepared yourself for CLAT, you need to go through these certain processes and you're not meant to give up. So do not give up. Not at least initially, no. Just give you 100% first and then see what works best for you. I have these 4 motivational videos which I used to watch a lot during my preparation and like even now. So just, I'll recommend you guys to go through them. These are like small helpful videos which also have scientific tips to study effectively and like how to stay motivated and all that stuff. Go through it. Yeah. So I have some miscellaneous questions that a lot of people ask me. So before you guys have these questions, I'll try to clarify it here only. How many mocks per week? It again depends on the time that you are in. For now that you have just started your preparation, you already don't know much, right? I'm not talking about droppers here, because droppers have an edge on the people who are like freshers. So for people who are going to take CLAT for the first time, you don't know much about the subject or the topics that you're going to cover. So take lesser mocks in the initial 3 months, like 1 mock per week, done. And for the droppers, you need to first work out on the sections that you got wrong, on the topics that you lag in, and then start practicing more and more mocks eventually according to your pace. Should you read newspaper daily? Now, newspaper can be of 18 pages, 23 pages, so you don't need to read every page, you need to read the relevant sections. Read national news, international news, editorials. And I think for initial days, it's enough because obviously you're preparing current affairs from a lot of different sources. But from if you have a habit of reading newspaper, it's just amazing. Plus read an offline paper because your paper is going to be offline. So just try to read these three pages of newspaper every day, national, international, editorial. And for GK and current affairs, you'll obviously be referring to a lot of online sources, which I've mentioned above. So that will be enough for you guys, I think. Studying from multiple sources which fetch you better marks, I already talked about this, and guys, it's a myth. Just bust it. It's not how it happens. If you just cover a lot of different portions, you'll be left with a pile of syllabus that you have covered, but you don't actually know about it in depth, right? And it's the difference between CLAT and IELTS is CLAT tests your depth of knowledge and IELTS tests your width of knowledge. So if you're preparing for IELTS, it's okay to know a lot of things and not in depth. But if you're preparing for CLAT, and this video is focused on CLAT, so it's important for you guys to know the depth of some very genuine and some very like predictable topics. Obviously, CLAT has a tendency to surprise you in the question paper. But then again, you know, you can broadly predict the topics, the sections that's going to come in your paper, and practice accordingly. So do not get disheartened by the fact that CLAT tends to surprise you in the paper, and so you don't eventually know what's gonna come. And then like, no matter what you study or how much you study, you'll eventually not be able to excel, because people do it every year, and so would you guys. CA portion, current affairs portion, should ideally be covered from July 2021 until 2 weeks before your exams. Yeah, that's it for this video, guys. But like, of course, you have any question, and just put it in the YouTube comment box. And whenever I'll get time, I'll for sure see it and reply to them to the best of my abilities. Yeah, good luck.